Hello, my name is Dr. Leland Ellison, and I am a computational physicist at Lawrence Livermore National Lab. What does that mean? In short, it means that I get to use the second largest computer in the world to simulate what happens at the number one largest laser facility. In this video, I also have two science demonstrations for you. In the first one, I'll be teaching you a cool little physics trick for telling whether or not an egg has been hard-boiled without cracking it open. And in the second demonstration, we will be super-cooling water. We'll be taking it just below its freezing point and then initiating the crystallization process all at once. It's a pretty remarkable effect.
Ooh.
First demonstration will teach you a handy trick for telling whether or not an egg has been hard-boiled. There, I have an assortment of fresh, not-boiled-at-all eggs. Here are a couple eggs in the process of getting hard-boiled on their way to becoming a delicious and nutritious treat. And there's the cat. So after 10 minutes of boiling, leaving the eggs to cool down for a little while, and foolishly leaving the finished product unattended on the counter for several minutes, I'm ready for my snack. Now, as everyone knows, the proper way to eat a hard-boiled egg is with a little mayonnaise. I like to just apply it straight on the shell on the outside. I find that leaving the shell on gives me a nice crunch. We need a pinch of salt, et finalement, a little crack of pepper. Bon appetit! It's not hard-boiled. So, we've learned a difficult lesson today. So what could we have done to prevent such a catastrophic accident from having taken place? From the outside, it is extremely difficult to tell whether an egg has been hard-boiled or not. They look pretty much the same. They're the same weight. No mass has escaped. If we cooled it down after we cooked them, then they're both going to be cold. But here's a cool trick. Here's an egg. I won't tell you which one it is. Let's see what happens when we spin it. Spins remarkably well. Look at it go, look at it go. On the other hand, let's try egg number two. That one didn't spin so well. Let's try them both up on their end. Spins quite a bit. Almost instantaneously stops. Take a minute and think to yourself, which of these do you think is hard-boiled and which one is not? So imagine that you're a soft yolk, nice round, heavy, dense piece of mass sitting inside the egg. As you get spun around, you're gonna slosh back and forth, you're gonna change what position you're in. It's that sloshing that makes the spinning so irregular in a fresh egg. One that does not spin as well is not hard-boiled. Meanwhile, with the hard-boiled egg, the yolk has been condensed, congealed into a solid matter, stays in the same spot all the time, and when we give it a spin, it just keeps right on going. So, I like to think that today we learned that every egg should be spun very aggressively before you venture on eating it, especially if you're gonna bite through the shell. For this demonstration, we need a couple of household items. Here I have some bottled water, came from the store, it needs to be very pure. I also have some tap water. You know it's tap because it says tap on it. Less pure, and it's going to help us tell when the other ones might be super cool. I also have some sea salt, nice and chunky, and a large vessel filled with ice, homemade, fresh from the freezer ice, and I have a jug of water, just good old tap water in there. So in this demonstration, I'm going to be super cooling water. That means we take water and cool it down below its normal freezing point 32 degrees Fahrenheit. And if the water is extremely pure, then we can get it that cold without forming that crystalline solid ice structure. But if we give it a good smack, we can initiate that crystallization process all at once, and it's a pretty interesting effect. So let's get started. And somewhere in my house, I have a thermometer where we can monitor the temperature of all this. Peel away some of the ice to see if my control tap water bottle has started to crystallize yet. Doesn't look like it, so let's keep waiting. Atticus is getting bored. Very sleepy. So my ice bath started to warm up. The water was getting to be 28, 29 degrees, and I didn't see any signs of freezing. So what I've actually done is taken them out and just put them in the freezer. I don't think they were going to freeze in the ice bath. As long as they were kind of at the same temperature when I put them in the freezer here, I should be able to tell when the pure water is super cooled based on when the tap water bottle gets frozen. So let's wait and see. Alright, so they've been in the freezer for about an hour after the ice bath. And would you look at that, one of them over on the right here is rock solid, and the other one is not. And now, let's see if we can get out our pure water one without initiating crystallization process. I'm really excited. I've never tried this before. You can see it's still in the liquid state. Air bubble in there somewhere. There. That's floating around. Okay, so what I'm gonna do next, it doesn't seem too sensitive. I'm gonna give it a good whack and see if we can kick off that crystallization process. Are you ready? Let's make sure we get a good view. Okay, ready. 3, 2, 1. Oh man, that is wicked cool. Oh man, that's awesome.
3, 2, 1.
Wow. So it got seated up by the cap and you could just watch that crystal structure form around the outside. So I don't know about you, but I've learned a lot today. I've learned that you should never bite into an egg, at least without spitting it first to see if it's hard-boiled. I learned that the cat is a crook who likes to switch around my hard-boiled eggs with the fresh ones. And I also learned a lot about the super cooling water demo. I tried it first in the ice bath. That was the first instructions I read, and they had some guidelines about how long it would take if you got it to a certain temperature. I think that was a bit difficult depending on the water you start with and the vessel it's in. I think it's gonna take different amounts of times. I ended up using all of the salt in the house. Sorry, Kelsey! And still didn't get it to freeze. So the freezer was better. Having a control bottle that had tap water in it was a really helpful tip. The things I'd encourage you to think about when trying this at home is to make sure that the two waters are starting at the same temperature. If you fill it with cold tap water and then you have a room temperature store-bought water bottle and you stick those in the freezer, it might not be a good indication of super cooling when your tap water bottle freezes. I also think it's important to make sure that the same bottle, you want to be trying to freeze the same volume of water and have the same surface to volume ratio for the cool. I thought that the effect was really worth trying at home. I thought it was very neat. Some might even say it was
super cool.
So now that you've heard how exciting it can be to be a physicist, some of you might be wondering what it takes to go into a career in science. So there is a lot of school involved. I went through 28 grades, which means that after I finished high school, I went to undergrad at the University of Colorado in Boulder for 4 years. And that's where I got really excited about plasma physics and fusion energy. I had a really fantastic mentor there who taught me a lot in his research lab and got me excited to head that direction. Then I went to graduate school at the Princeton Plasma Physics Lab for 6 years. So graduate school isn't really like the classroom school that you guys are familiar with. It involves a little bit of classroom work, but it's mostly doing research. So I spent 6 years learning physics there, and I finished my PhD and went on to Lawrence Livermore. If you liked this video, please check out the Learning with Leland YouTube series on Lawrence Livermore National Lab's webpage. You can see me do all sorts of fun things like have swim caps dropped on my head and tried to feed my car donuts. See you next time. And that got me really excited to keep pursuing that in my graduate school. Atticus is attacking a lizard.
Making a friend?
What happened to his tail? Atticus is like, this is my new favoritist thing. He's trying to bite him. Okay.